Good evening.
Hello, hello, good evening, welcome.
Thank
How
you.
Are you?
I'm fine, teacher, and you?
I'm nice, it's raining here in my house. I don't know where you are.
Oh, no.
It's not raining?
No, here is not raining.
Where are you, Aitia?
In Ayutuxtepeque.
Ah, Ayutuxtepeque, close to San Salvador.
And it's very, very hot.
Yeah, I can imagine.
It
is hot. Even though it's raining, it is extremely hot. I'm in Quetzaltepeque, La Libertad. And what about you, Fidel? Where are you right now?
Here in San Salvador too, San Marcos.
Oh, okay.
But just, you're gonna see thunder or not.
Okay. Nice. So you are almost from the capital, from the main city.
Yes.
What about you, Astrid? Where are you? Astrid Maria?
Hello, teacher.
Hi, how are you?
I am in San Marcos.
San Marcos too. Okay. Nice. Okay. So probably then when the raining finish here, so we'll travel and move on to the to where you are. So I'm in Quetzaltepeque, kind of far, not too much, but it's kind of far from San Salvador, the main country. Thank you, Lisbeth, for the camera. Thank you, Jessica, Herbert. Nice to see you. So we are right now 11 participants. We will wait for the rest to join. Okay, Irene. Thank you for the message. Edwin, welcome, Eugenia. Nice to see you, Eugenia. Where
Thank
are you.
You,
Eugenia?
I'm doing fine. I'm fine.
Okay, so you are in San Salvador?
Yes.
Ah, okay, so you are 100% capitalina.
No 100% because I'm from Usulután.
Ah, okay, so you are from there, but you are living in the in San Salvador.
Yes, we moved here when I was 15 years old.
Ah, okay, so
you are
more from San Salvador than from Usulután.
By now, yes, but my heart is Usulután.
Okay, nice.
I love my
the countryside. Nice. Lisbeth, what are you doing, Lisbeth? Hello, can you hear me? Lisbeth Alvarado. Okay, you have signal problems. Okay, that's why I see that you are like stand up. Trying to be very close to the router. Okay. So probably it's raining where you are, Lisbeth. So you don't have good connection. Okay, no problem, Lisbeth. So try to see if you have a, if you are next to the router.
Lo siento, escucho cortado y me tengo que andar moviendo, no lo escuché.
Ah, okay, okay, Lisbeth. Okay, thank you, no problem. So. Hopefully, probably, I don't know if it is raining where you are, but probably it's because if it is raining. Okay, welcome, Edwin. Thank you, Harold. Thank you, Hilda Milagro. Welcome, Jessica. Nice to see you. Thank you, Glenda. Nice to see you.
Nice.
Harold, and what happened with your classmate that it's always right there next to you? He disappeared today.
Regular, teacher, regular.
Okay, no, I'm asking you, Harold, for your I don't know, your friend who is always next to you. What happened to him? Did you get the question?
Yo creo que hoy no está.
Okay. Ah, okay. Se perdió ahora, se va a perder la clase. Okay, nice. Okay. So let's see who else is joining the meeting. Daniel, your cameras. Don't forget to have your cameras on all the time. Thank you, Angie. Thank you, Daniel. Now I see you. And Maricela, welcome, Maricela. Nice to see you. Okay. So let's see. Diana Lisbeth is joining. Jefferson, Ana, Ana Guerra, ya viene apareciendo Ana Guerra. Nice. Ana Victoria, Ingrid, I don't see your cameras. Eneida is joining the meeting right now. We are 23 participants, okay? So we are going to start with the attendance, okay? So like every day, remember we have to pass the attendance in twice, right? At the beginning and also at the end. So let's see, today is Monday 19th. And let's see, Ana Astrid Cortez.
I'm here, teacher.
Thank you. Ana Bernarda Guerra.
Here, teacher.
Thank you, just on time, Ana. Ana Cristina Cabrera. Ana Cristina. No. Ana Lisbeth Alvarado, ahí está. Ana Miriam Guevara. Ana Miriam Guevara. No. Ana Victoria Avilés. Victoria Avilés. No. Angie Elizabeth López, ahí está Angie.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Carla Raquel.
Yes, I'm here, I'm here.
Angie. Carla Raquel.
Ana Victoria.
Ah, ok, Ana Victoria. Déjeme si le cambio aquí porque le puse que no estaba. Ana Victoria, Angie y Carla. Carla Raquel. Carla, Carla, no la he visto. Carla, entrar. Ok, let's see, probably later. Cindy Arely. Cindy Arely. Aldana, no. Cordelia Elizabeth, Cordelia, no. Daniel Edgardo,
present.
Thank you, Daniel. Diana Lisbeth, Diana,
present, teacher.
Thank you. Doris Maricela,
present, teacher.
Thank you. Edwin Edgardo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Edwin Aiton.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Eneida Patricia.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Erika Eloisa. Erika. No. Eugenia Asuncion.
I'm here, teacher.
Thank you. Fidel Natanael.
Here.
Thank you. Francisco Javier.
Hey, teacher.
Thank you, Francisco. German Mejia. German. No. Glenda Annette.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Glenda. Harold Eduardo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Herbert Douglas.
Here, teacher.
Thank you. Hilda Milagro.
Here, teacher.
Thank you. Ingrid Xiomara.
Present, miss.
Thank you. Irene Beatriz.
I'm here, teacher.
Thank you. Jaime Antonio. No. Jefferson Mauricio.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Jefferson. Jessica Guadalupe.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Okay, did I mention all of you or there is someone that I mentioned and was not here? Yes?
No puedo ver mi cámara ahora.
Ah, okay.
So, yo...
so you are, let's see who? Who was talking? Daniel. ¿Quién era el que me... Jefferson. Jefferson Mauricio.
Sí, teacher.
Ah, okay, okay. So, let's see, did I mention all of you or... ¿Alguien no lo ha, ya lo había mencionado y después ingresó? ¿No? Okay, so try to be with your cameras if you can, please. Sé que hay algunos casos ahí que tienen problemas con la cámara, pero it's just one or two. Then the rest, we need to have the cameras on. Thank you for the ones that have the cameras. And remember that today, some of you were like texting me. Ah, teacher, what happened? Look, they are sending me a message that I'm not in the class and that I don't have the 80% of the work, and I'm worried because I was always there. And ya me estaban ahí. De que usted no me ha puesto la asistencia. Usted, yo he estado. Yo sé. But the thing is not that. The thing is that they send the message to all of the members, okay? No es que se lo han mandado directamente a usted. Ese mensaje se lo han mandado a todos, a toditos. So if you know that you are in the class every single day that we have class, and that you are the whole hour or even more, okay? And that you already work on the platform, ese mensaje no es para usted. Usted debe estar al 100 o probably almost in 100, okay? So when they say that you need to be in 80% at least, they mean that it's about the whole platform. No es hasta la unidad 1, no es al 80% de la unidad 2, de la unidad 3. Ellos le dicen el 80% que usted debe de tener en toda la plataforma, desde la unidad 1 hasta la unidad 5. Ok, probablemente por eso le están diciendo también, usted no está en 100, porque no está tal vez hasta el final. Hay como una o dos personas que sí están en 100, en todo. Ya terminaron todos los ejercicios. Ok, entonces si usted está completo, no es que usted lo van a sacar o es para usted el mensaje, sino que el mensaje se ha enviado de manera general a todos, para que ustedes puedan hacer el proceso de inscripción, puedan enviar la información que ustedes deben de enviar al correo que se les ha dado. No me lo manden a mí, no lo manden en el grupo del WhatsApp. Miren, aquí está, mándelo al correo, porque ellos han sido bien claros y toda información que llegue así, que miren que aquí mandó fulano, o mire, salgo yo y le digo, mire, aquí sutanito me mandó, no me lo van a validar. Tiene que ser un correo directamente de usted al correo que ellos le han brindado, donde usted va a enviar la información. No sé cuántos ya recibieron la evaluación. Hay una encuesta de satisfacción, hay una encuesta donde me van a evaluar a mí. Ahí aparecen todos los maestros que imparten clases en diferentes horarios, en diferentes modalidades. Ustedes deben de buscar mi nombre. Mi nombre es Luz Beatriz Guzmán Renderos. Aunque se acuerde de Luz Guzmán, ahí usted lo busca, porque si no le va a poner el 10 a otro. Y tiene que ponérmelo a mí.
I did that. I remember that you are Luz Guzmán. I look for Luz Guzmán.
Ah, okay. Perfect. Okay, perfect. Sí, eso es algo que nos dijeron que le recordáramos. Y este, hay que hacer esa encuesta. Trate de usted hacer las cosas con tiempo. No vaya a estar el último día ahí, porque ellos necesitan enviar esos documentos a INSAFOR, necesitan validar toda esa información. Acuérdense que esto es una logística la que se lleva para que el convenio siga, para que INSAFOR siga apoyando cada una de sus clases. Pero si nosotros no mandamos nada, entonces dan a entender pues que no estamos interesados y le dan la oportunidad a otra persona, ¿verdad? Así es que ustedes pónganse muy al día con eso, la plataforma, trabajen. El fin de semana les estuve mandando ahí un par de mensajitos, algunos hasta me escribieron aparte que los había despertado. porque dormidos estaban todavía como a las 11 de la mañana y los levanté a trabajar a la plataforma, pero así es. Así es, la vida del estudiante no siempre es color de rosa. La vida del estudiante es complicada porque hay que ser responsable, porque usted quiere aprender. Y yo se los dije desde el primer día, no le voy a decir que esto es fácil. No, ¿por qué? Porque ustedes trabajan, ustedes tienen otras obligaciones, son padres de familia, tienen hijos, tienen esposo, tienen gato, tienen perro en la casa, lo que sea. Usted una responsabilidad, algo tiene que hacer, ¿verdad? No son personas que están ahí pues en la calle viendo qué pasa, quién va, quién viene. O sea, son personas ocupadas. Más sin embargo, ustedes han hecho el esfuerzo de querer superarse, querer aprender un segundo idioma y después un tercero, un cuarto, un quinto, qué sé yo. O sea, pero hay que esforzarse. Si yo les contara, lo voy a aburrir, pero si yo les contara, a veces a mí me dicen, ah, pero es que usted, teacher, ¿por qué fue a Estados Unidos quizás y por allá aprendí y no sé qué? Pero no, o sea, el inglés, mi inglés es aquí. Yo sí he salido del país, no he ido a Estados Unidos, pero no es que porque he viajado o porque no, yo empecé así una clase como ustedes y yo era presencial en ese momento, right? Hace que 8, 9, 10 años atrás y yo llegué y me senté ahí en el salón y yo salí y dije yo, no entendí nada. Yo veía que la maestra hablaba y yo lo que yo hacía era fijarme qué hacían los demás. Yo veía que todos abrían el libro y yo abría el libro, pero no era porque yo había entendido que la maestra decía abran el libro en la página 20. Yo veía que escribían y yo veía que estaban escribiendo y yo me ponía a escribir en lo cual sea. Así se los digo que así fue. O sea, yo he estudiado en escuelas públicas, ¿verdad? Nunca he ido a colegios en lo público. Ustedes saben lo difícil que es. Más sin embargo, pues en esa clase yo dije, a mí me gusta el inglés, a mí me gusta y algún día yo voy a entender lo que la maestra está diciendo. Y así empecé. Yo necia, iba, no entendía nada, pero yo ahí estaba. Algo se me iba a pegar. Y miren que 10 años después, cómo cambian las cosas. Así se puede. Pero imagínense, le estoy hablando que yo llevo en esto más de 10 años. Entonces, ahora, para aprender un lenguaje, para comunicarse, usted lo puede aprender en 3 meses, dicen algunas academias. Puede aprender a medio comunicarse, pero se necesita esfuerzo. Entonces, yo los animo a que trabajen en la plataforma. Yo sé que algunos me dicen, pero es que mire, yo la pongo buena la pregunta y ese volado me lo tira malo. Pero hay que fijarse bien. Hay que fijarse bien si es mayúscula, si es minúscula, si va contractado, si va en positivo, si es negativo, si he dado doble espacio. O sea, deben ustedes de ser muy cuidadosos. Y por esa parte quizás está bien que la plataforma sea así, porque no lo va a dejar pasar si está malo. Entonces, trabajemos en la plataforma, por favor. Ya tengo ahí el récord de las notas y me tomé la tarea de escribirle personalmente a las personas que estaban más atrasadas, ¿verdad? Casi que no los he dejado respirar el fin de semana. Ahí como que soy la mamá de ustedes siguiéndolos para que hagan la tarea. Pero la verdad es que debemos de hacerlo. Así que gracias por los que están completos o están ya bastante avanzados, porque espero que en esta semana nos esforcemos y que el sábado estemos en 100. Ya la otra semana lo tomamos para finalizar la última unidad y repasar y revisar y hacer alguna actividad, porque el tiempo va. Y primero Dios, terminamos un módulo y seguimos el otro. No tenemos que hacer una pausa, sino se nos va a olvidar lo que hemos aprendido. Debemos de darle forma, pero para que ustedes sigamos con la siguiente clase, todos deben de enviar la documentación, los papeles y todo lo que ellos les están pidiendo. Porque si el grupo también no se llena, no se apertura. Debemos de estar los que estamos para que la clase continúe, ¿verdad? Yo de mi parte esperaría que terminamos ahora el 3, nos pasamos al 4 mañana y así, para que le demos ese seguimiento y ustedes sientan pues que el aprendizaje se va alcanzando. Así es que los dejo con esa pequeña introducción, ya me tomé mucho tiempo, pero es bien importante que trabajemos en la plataforma, que estemos en toda la jornada de nuestra clase, porque ellos eso es lo que van a tomar en cuenta. Usted me puede decir, mire, es que yo le juro que yo ahí estaba, yo le puedo creer, yo no le voy a decir, mire, no, mentira, usted nunca estuvo ahí. Yo le voy a decir, sí, es cierto, usted ahí estaba, pero ellos, acá está todo grabado. No hay cómo engañar y ahí en la grabación sale quién estaba presente, quién salió, quién entró, quién se desconectó, a qué horas usted se conectó, a qué horas usted se desconectó. Y ante eso, pues, no hay otra validación, pues ahí el sistema lo dice claramente. Entonces, eso tómenlo en cuenta, ¿verdad? El tiempo de la conexión que usted debe de ser respetado para que no tengamos ningún problema. So, let's start. Please do the evaluation. Okay, si alguien va ingresando, les están mandando una información para evaluar al maestro. Luz Guzmán es mi nombre, usted me va a evaluar a mí. Y ahí usted es libre de poner, ¿verdad?, algo que usted desee. Igual, si tienen algún comentario, un feedback, positive, negative, una observación. Mire, maestra, a mí no me gusta esas letras que usted pone ahí que se mueven. Ya no las ponga. Yo las quito, usted me puede decir, ¿verdad? Para eso somos un equipo y yo estoy abierta pues a aceptar sus observaciones. Así es que eso, ¿verdad? Bien, so welcome back. Okay, welcome back and let's start with this. We have a recap right here. Okay, so what is a recap? It's a try to keep in mind, try to remember what we did, what we learned from last week. Let's see, Jessica Mancilla, mention something that you remember from the previous classes, not just the last one, desde el día uno, lo que se acuerde.
Sobre las direcciones.
Okay, directions, what else? You can go ahead and see your notes. You can review your notes. Para los que van anotando ahí, revisen. Okay, yes. So.
Las prepositions of place.
Oh, perfect. Preposition of place. Let's see, Herbert. Give me one example, one sentence using a preposition, please.
Please.
Yeah, Herbert, just give me one example, one sentence using a preposition. That is something that we learned last week, okay, about prepositions. We have between, next to, in front, in, on, out, inside. Did you remember behind?
Okay, I am in front of my computer beside the
okay, perfect, nice. I am in front of the computer right now, okay, for your English class, nice. Edwin, give me another example. Edwin Garcia, give me another example using a preposition of place.
Okay, the bank is across from the park.
Okay, the bank is across of the bank. Okay, oh, nice. Yeah. Perfect. Let's see, Hilda Milagro. Mention something else that you remember from previous classes, please.
About going to, and does mean about future plans or make predictions based on evidence.
Okay, future, going to. We mentioned that we are going to use going to for expressions in the future, right? When we say, oh, I'm going to visit my parents during the weekend. Okay, let's see. Eugenia, give me an example using going to.
Okay, this Wednesday I'm going to go to the beach with my family.
Okay, perfect. So I'm going to go to the beach with my family this coming Wednesday. Nice. Okay, nice. Let's see. Angie Lopez, another example using going to.
We are going to the guitar.
We are going to what? One more time, I'm sorry.
The guitar.
We are going to play the guitar, probably, right? So we are going to play the guitar tomorrow. Okay, that can be a plan. Nice. Let's see, Ana Guerra, mention something else that you remember from previous classes, please. You're on mute. I'm sorry, Anna. You are on mute.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
The previous question, a word new, which, for me, new, which and often.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Anna. Remember WH questions, okay? And Anna mentioned the which, okay? Let's see. Maricela Dueñas, give me an example using which, the WH question, which.
Where are you going to buy?
But that is using where, okay? Where is for a place, where you are going to buy the your new pair of shoes, okay? But with which, let's see, Diana. Thank you, Maricela. Let's see, Diana Lisbeth, give me an example using which.
See?
Give me an example using which, the WH question, okay? Remember that we have different WH questions, okay? No es solo uno, hay varios. So, Anna mentioned that the new one for her is which. What? Go ahead. I'm sorry, I guess you have inconvenience with your internet because you are like cutting off. Well, I don't know if it is my, but I was not able to listen. But don't worry, Fidel, give us the example, please, using which.
let's see which you see me bloqueado. I'm blocked.
Oh my god.
Which type of bakery do you need? I don't know if it's good.
Yeah, or... remember that we mentioned that which is when you have options.
Choose. Uh-huh, yes, you have to choose.
Okay, uh-huh, which one do you prefer? Which one do you prefer? The white one or the black one? Okay, which is your favorite color, pink or blue?
Okay? I think which is some difficult to think about that.
Yeah, the thing is because we don't have probably many words, but it's easy because we use it in Spanish, okay?
Yes,
we use the WH in Spanish, okay?
Okay.
Nice, but thank you, Fidel. Let's see. ¿Qué se me hizo Lisbeth Alvarado? Ya no la veo. Is this Lisbeth? Are you here, Lisbeth, at the end? I don't know. You still have issues with your internet. I don't know. Okay, probably, yes. Let's see, Daniel. Daniel, give me an example with a different WH question. Another one, WH.
Okay, teacher. What is your favorite color?
Okay, what is your favorite color? Another one?
When do you go? When do you go the last week? Where do you live?
Okay, perfect. Okay, so keep in mind the WH questions, okay? So let's continue because of the time, okay? Thank you, Aitel. Help me with the reading, please. Read the lesson and the model objective, the objective.
Okay. 3.11, lesson objective. By the end of this class, you will develop skills in reading for details and making inferences.
Okay, perfect. By the end of this class, it says you will develop skills in reading for details and making inferences. Okay, what is an inference? Do you have any idea? Do you know like the meaning of this word?
No, I don't know.
Okay, so it says like reading for details, okay? When you are reading, if you are reading a book or something, so you can underline like the main ideas, right? Viene usted y va subrayando lo más importante, dice usted, lo más relevante del texto, right? So you are probably searching for details. Making inferences means your opinion, okay? Cuando usted da su opinión, cuando usted opina, dice el texto, oh, las aves son animales que anidan sus huevos, qué sé yo, un texto de aves. Y usted opina, y usted dice, no, mi opinión es que sí, las aves tienen el hábitat de poder reproducirse, y usted empieza a opinar based on the reading, okay? It's like your opinion, okay? That's inferences, okay? So let's see what we have right here. We have a reading that we are going to do it in small groups, okay? So we are going to create right now, let me see, 4 groups, okay? So this reading, if you are not able to see the letters because this is just a picture, so you can see it in your manual, okay? Ahí lo tienen ustedes en su manual, en la plataforma, so you can read it from there if you are not able to see the letters. So what you are going to do, I will do 4 groups, okay? I will create 4 groups, and what you will do in the group is read the text, okay? But it will be just the part. For example, we have group number 1, so you will read just the text that is number 1, okay? This one. If you are in the group number 2, so you will read this one in your group. If you are number 3, this one, and if you are number 4, this one. No lo va a leer todo, va a leer el número que a usted le corresponda, okay? So then, when you read it, please, if you have any new work or something that you don't know what it is, so get together, that's why you will be in a group, and you can discuss, okay, the idea, what is the meaning. And then you will have to choose one for each group, like a leader, okay, and the person is going to explain, okay, in their own words, what is the reading about, okay? No me lo tiene que volver a leer, usted me va a explicar lo que ahí dice, okay? That is making inferences, okay? So you will give me your own opinion or your own explanation based on the reading. I don't know if we have questions or if it is everything is clear. Si se comprende la activity, right? Yes. So let me create the groups. Okay, I'm going to stop sharing and I'm going to create the groups. En el grupo que a usted le toque, yo le voy a decir quién es el grupo 1, 2, 3 y 4. Ese va a leer usted. Okay, and then you are going to discuss with the group, okay? I will give you like 7 minutes, okay? No les puedo dar más tiempo, like 7 minutes for you to read the paragraph and may take details on the reading and explain, okay, to me and to the whole class the idea of the reading, okay? No me va a leer a mí, me va a explicar lo que ahí dice, okay? So, escogen a uno nada más. Yo sé que todos quieren explicarlo, pero por el tiempo solo vamos a seleccionar a uno, okay? Ustedes deciden ahí a quién ponen de víctima ahí, okay? So, let's do it right now, okay? Let's do it right now. Vaya, fíjense bien, el grupo número uno es donde está Ana Guerra, Eneida, Fidel, Glenda, Jefferson, Mauricio. Group number two, Ana Victoria, Eugenia, Herbert, Hilda, Ingrid, Xiomara, Jaime. Number three, Angie, Daniel, Edwin, Eichel, Harold, Irene López. And number four, Astrid, Edwin García, Javier, Lisbeth Alvarado, and Marisela Dueña. So let's go to the rooms. Hello, Glenda, can you hear me? Hello, hello, Glenda. Oh, you are in two devices, I guess, Glenda. Diana Lisbeth, can you hear me?
¿Sí?
Yeah, I'm going to give you a room. La voy a mandar a un room.
Ajá, es que se me había desconectado.
Ok. Glenda Portillo, can you hear me? Hi, Glenda.
Teacher, este, tengo mal inter, entonces me estoy conectando a cada rato.
Okay.
Me salgo y...
Sí, así veo. Ok, la voy a asignar al room number 3.
Va, está bien.
Thank you. Hello, hello. Ajá. So, just one volunteer, ok. Yo sé que en este equipo todos van a querer explicar, right? I see your faces, but it's just one, okay? Try to read and try to understand what is the reading about, and you are going to explain with your own words what is the reading, okay? So, bye-bye. I will visit the other group, okay?
Okay.
Librería Pública de Nueva York, que la entrada para esto está entre la 42 y la entre la 40 y 42 calle, y que en la librería hay más de 10 millones de libros. Atrás de esta librería está Bryant Park, que es un lugar en el cual durante el verano hay un café al aire libre, y a la hora del almuerzo pueden haber conciertos de música.
Amazing, okay, but now in English.
I asked,
okay.
sorry teacher, I asked about it in Spanish.
Okay.
Sorry, it's my fault. It's my fault.
Okay, so we have 2 more minutes, okay?
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Nice. Hello, hello, almost ready. I'm just visiting. Lo ando visitando por aquí.
For me, it's okay. Good, teacher.
Nice, Daniel. Thank you. So, I
for me, it's good, you visiting.
Nice. So, you're ready almost. We have 1 more minute, okay? Remember that it's just one. Okay, the one that will explain what is the reading about. Okay.
I'm already ready for that.
Perfect. So I'm going to visit the other group, okay?
Okay, teacher. Thanks.
Model, pero es que no se lo podemos repetir.
Ajá, what happened? Hello, I'm just visiting right here to see if everything is okay. What is your question, Astrid?
I don't know what is the meaning and leave the noise city behind. El contexto.
Teacher, está en mute.
Oh my God, I'm mute. Yeah, it says, go inside the St. Patrick and leave the noise city behind. So the noise city, it's ruido. Okay, so when you get into the cathedral, that's a church. Okay, so you forget about the, rah, 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 the noise outside. So that's why it says, go inside St. Patrick and leave the noise city behind, so deja el ruido a un lado, because inside it's extremely quiet, okay, peaceful, okay. Oh, no. So, time is over, okay, so ya los visité a todos, solo ustedes me faltaban, so you are ready? Yes?
No.
Astrid, está ready, teacher.
Okay, Astrid and Edwin, you look ready, okay, so nice.
Edwin.
So, okay, Edwin. So we are going to come back to the main room. Okay, welcome back. Welcome back.
Hello.
Nice, perfect. So welcome back. So let's see, group number one. Let me share the screen one more time. Yes, okay, here we go. Let me share it. So let's see, one of the members can probably read the article and the other person will explain, okay? Pueden uno leerlo. That way we have an idea and then the other, it's going to explain, okay? What is the chart or the passage or the article or the reading about, okay? So group number one, go ahead. No sé quién lo va a leer y quién lo va a explicar. Group number one.
Si gusta lo leo yo, teacher, y el compañero que lo explique, si está de acuerdo.
Go ahead.
Okay. Start your tour at the Empire State Building
on Fifth Avenue between 3rd and 34th Street. This building has 102 floors. Take the elevator to the
one hundred second
floor for a great view of New York City.
Okay, thank you. Next.
Okay, if you visit United States, you have to visit New York. Okay, and in New York has the Empire State Building. You start your tour there on the Fifth Avenue and the 30th and 40th streets. If you gonna see the most beautiful view of the city, you have to take the elevator and go to this 102nd floor, and you have a nice view.
Okay? Oh, perfect. Thank you. Nice. Perfect. Let's see. Group number two. The same story. One can read the article and the other one can explain. Let's see. Go ahead.
Number two, we decide who wants to explain, but no, who can read. I don't know with my...
So, Hilda, I guess you are with her, right?
Yes.
Okay, so Hilda, you can read it, and Eugenia, you can explain, no problem.
Okay. Now walk up Fifth Avenue, 7 blocks to the New York Public Library. The entrance is between 4th and 42nd streets. This library, I don't see much.
Holds
over 10 million books. Behind the library is Bryant Park. In the summer, there's an outdoor cafe, and at lunch hour, there are free music concerts.
Perfect, thank you. Continue, Hen. You are on mute, Eugenia. Eugenia, you are on, okay.
Okay, that is, we visit New York and we walk up for Fifth Avenue. We can find the New York Public Library. And this library holds over more than 10 million books. That's a big quantity of books. And the entrance for the library, we can find it between the 14th and 42nd streets. And behind the library, we can find the Bryant Park. On summertime, they hold free music concert in the outdoor cafe and for at lunch hour.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Nice. Continue, number three. Who's number three?
I'm ready, teacher.
Okay, go ahead, Daniel.
Okay. Walk up 6th Avenue to 49th Street. You're standing in the middle lane of the 19 buildings of Rockefeller Center. Turn right on 49th Street, walk another block, and turn left. You're in Rockefeller Plaza. In the winter, you can ice skate in the rink there.
Okay, perfect. Now who's going to explain?
Ahí le estoy diciendo, el que está dirigiendo le dice...
In English, Harold.
In English?
Yes, of course.
I don't know, teacher.
Remember that what you would need to do is try to explain, okay, what is this short paragraph about? I see that it's about the Rockefeller Center. Do you know what is the Rockefeller Center? If Harold, you are not ready, so alguien más del equipo 3 puede apoyar.
Okay. Someone is giving direction how to get to Rockefeller Plaza since 6th Avenue. He says that how to walk to 49th Street. And he will turn right on 49th Street and walk one more block and turn left. And he is in Rockefeller Plaza. In winter, there is an ice skate in the rink there.
Okay, thank you, Aitel. So that's what it says, right? It's like giving you the direction how you can search or walk, because of the Rockefeller Center is a huge place. It's not a small place. So you have to walk and walk and walk and walk. And it's giving you how you can get to the Rockefeller Plaza. Okay, thank you. Let's see, group number four. Who is going to read? Group number four.
Okay, teacher.
Javier, so go ahead.
Yes. Okay, right across from Rockefeller Center on Sixth Avenue is Street Patrick's Cathedral. It's modeled after the cathedral in Cologne, right? Okay, Germany, go inside Street Patrick's and leave the noisy city behind. Look at the beautiful blue windows. Many of these windows come from France.
Thank you. Nice. Continue.
Me, teacher.
Thank you, Esther.
On Fifth Avenue, we found St. Patrick Cathedral. It's a silent and quiet place where you can leave the noise of the city and relax time. Its structure is amazing, with beautiful blue windows. These windows come from France.
Oh, perfect. Thank you. Nice, Angie. I like it. Nice. Yes. Okay. So this is a cathedral. Okay. The St. Patrick Cathedral. And it says that it's beautiful. It's really quiet. So there are no noise right there. There is no noisy. So, and the windows are so beautiful. It says blue windows that they are from France, as Angie mentioned. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Let's continue. Okay. Let's see. We have right here some questions, okay? And it says, ask the questions to your classmates, okay? And look at the activities that we have right here. We have two words, probably, I don't know if they are new for you, but we have right here, where you can do blah, 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 outdoors. And where you can do blah, 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 indoors. Okay, we have different activities, okay? We have different activities like this ones in the pictures. If you see, they are like games, okay? Cycling, basketball, tennis, running, swimming, skiing, volleyball, football, and there are other ones. I guess that all of these are outdoor activities, okay? But we also can do indoors activities. So those ones are the ones that you do inside of your house, inside of a school, inside of a place. For example, chess. You know what is playing or chess? You know yes. What is? Okay, yes, so that's a... Yes. That's an indoor activity, right? That's an indoor. You don't have to be outside to do it. So you can do also the different table games that we have. So those are like table games, okay? Table games, so they are indoors, okay? You can go and read a book That's an activity that you can do indoor, okay? So let's watch a movie, okay? That's something that you will do indoor. So let's see, we have a few more. Oh my God, it's almost time. So we are going to ask the questions, okay? Let's see who. Let's see, Herbert, where you can do running, okay? Outdoors activity, where you can running. Where you can run in. Where? I'm asking you where, okay? Acuérdense, este es donde, where?
On the street.
Okay, complete sentence. Complete the answer.
I can run on the street.
Perfect, okay? That can be, I can run on the street, okay? Or in the field, soccer field,
on
okay?
The park.
On the park, okay, at the park. Nice. Let's see, Jaime Garcia, where you can play volleyball. Where you can play volleyball?
I miss, I can where, pardon, sorry, where in, ah, no sé cómo se dice cancha de fútbol.
Field, okay. So I can play tennis. Or volleyball. I'm sorry, I say volleyball. I can play volleyball in the field, okay? In the field or at the beach, right? At the beach.
Ah, volleyball. Okay.
Volleyball.
Ah,
nice.
Volleyball. Ah, pues, okay, basketball.
Oh, I say volleyball, okay? So look, no problem, thank you. Because of the time, so we are going to stop, but we do have this conversation practice, okay, pending. So tomorrow we are going to continue with this, okay? So one more time, please try to work in the platform. Así se lo digo, trabajen en la plataforma. No quiero que a alguien le vayan a decir, ¿verdad?, que ya no va a poder continuar porque no ha trabajado. Ahora bien, yo estoy tratando de ayudarles, la respuesta yo no se las puedo dar, porque algunos me dicen, pero es que dígame cuál pongo. Yo le puedo ayudar, dar un tip, ¿verdad?, a ayudarle dándole un ejemplo, pero tampoco no me diga que le dé la respuesta, o que mire, le voy a dar mi usuario, hágamelo. Tampoco, ¿verdad? O sea, no podemos hacer eso, pero sí les pido de la manera más atenta que trabajemos, please. Do your part, okay? Do your part, and at the end, so we need to be in 100, okay? Si se equivoca en una, no hay problema. No va a tener 100, pero va a tener un 96, un 97, okay? Y you are good. Pero no tiene que tener menos de 80, porque hay algunos que han dejado unos ejercicios en 37, en 62, en 75. Y está ahí, no, ahí está reprobado. So remember that it's 80 at least. Okay. So let me pass the attendance one more time. And please say yes that you are here. Okay. Let's see. Ana Astrid.
I'm here.
Thank you. Ana Bernarda. Thank you. Ana Cristina. Ana Cristina? Ana Lisbeth?
I'm here, teacher.
Thank you, Ana Miriam. Ana Victoria?
Here.
Thank you. Angie Elizabeth?
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Carla Raquel? Carla no la vi ahora. Carla Raquel? No. Cindy Areli? Aldana, Cindy, no. Cordelia Elizabeth, no. Daniel Edgardo.
Present.
Thank you, Diana Lisbeth.
Present.
Thank you, Doris Marisela.
Present.
Thank you, Edwin Edgardo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Edwin Acho.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Eneida Patricia.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Erica Eloisa. Erica, Eugenia Asunción.
Present, miss.
Thank you, Fidel.
Here I am.
Thank you, Francisco.
Present.
Thank you, Glenda. I'm sorry, German Mejia. German, no. Glenda Annette. Glenda. Harold Eduardo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Harold. Herbert Douglas.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Hilda Milagro.
Here, teacher.
Thank you. Ingrid Xiomara.
Present, miss.
Thank you. Irene Beatriz.
Here, teacher.
Thank you. Jaime Antonio.
I present, miss.
Thank you. Jefferson Mauricio.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jessica Guadalupe.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. So don't forget that tomorrow we have class, okay? Wednesday and Thursday, okay? The whole week for us. So thank you so much for being on time and for being on the class. Please do your part as students. And if you need help or if you have any question about any exercise, yeah, let me know, okay? I will try to do my best to help you out, okay? So thank you. See you tomorrow, okay? Enjoy the rest of the night. And I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Cuídense.
See you tomorrow. Good night, everybody.
Tomorrow.
Good night. Bye-bye.
See you tomorrow, brother.
See you to all.